discuss digital to analog converter. So our input is the n-bit binary word. So which is combined with the reference voltage VR to give the analog output voltage. So this is the block diagram of the digital to analog converter. So input is the n binary word. So we combine with the reference voltage, we will get the output voltage is the analog output. So this is one digital to analog converter. So here the output voltage in D2A converter is, so we are mathematically written as, so V0 equal to K into VFS multiple with D1 2 power minus 1 plus D2 2 power minus 2 plus up to Dn 2 power minus n. So D1 to Dn is the, D1 is, D1 to Dn is the binary, it is the n-bit binary fractional word. So here K is represent the full, K is represent the scaling factor, which is usually adjusted to unity. So yeah, VFS is the full scale output voltage. So our output voltage is V0. So here D1 is the MSB bit, Dn is the LSB bit. LSB bit. So here we have the various types of digital to analog converter is there. So the first one is the binary weighted register type, binary weighted register type D2A converter, then R2 to R radar type D2A converter, then voltage mode and current mode R2 to R radar type converter. So we'll see one by one. So the first one is the weighted, binary weighted register type D2A converter. So here is the inputs are binary weighted. So how can we can say that it is binary weighted register is inputs are binary weighted. So here the binary weights are two. It starts from 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3 up to we have the 2 power n. So these registers are connected with the inverting mode of the amplifier. Then the non-inverting terminal is connected to the ground. So here this connected to this binary weighted register is connected to inverting mode as well as the another end is connected to the reference voltage, right? So here the reference voltage is given to the inverting mode through the binary weighted register. Binary weighted register. So here we have the reference voltage is there. Here we have the resistance is there. So current flows through the each resistance we are consider. It is I1 to In. So here I1, this is I2 up to we have 2 power n is there. So current flows through the 2 power n R resistor is In. So here we use the different type of switches, that is single throw, double throw switch or TTL, transistor logic switch. So based on the switches, so the reference voltage is either positive or negative. So here we use the SBDT switch. So the reference voltage is the negative polarity. So here it is the electronic switch. So this switch is controlled by the binary word. So our input is the binary word. Okay, it is either 0 or 1. So the binary input is converted into analog output. So here the binary is input is zero means the switch is connected to the reference voltage. The binary input is zero means the switch is connected to the ground. It is zero means it is one means which is connected to the reference voltage. Okay, then it is zero means which is connected to the ground. So now we analyze this input circuit. So the input circuit is here. We are apply the Kirchhoff's current law at node A. So how we write the current equations? The current equation is the VA minus V0, first the output voltage, VA minus V0 divided by the reference voltage. The next one is VA minus of minus VR. Here the resistance is weighted resistance, binary weighted resistance. So 2 power 1 R. So multiple with D1. Okay, the next one is the VA minus of the reference voltage. So here divide by the 2 power 2, the resistance value. Resistance value is 2 power 2 R multiple with D2. So up to we have the VA minus of minus VR multiple with the Dn divide by we have the 2 power n R. So now apply the Kirchhoff's current law, we'll get this equation. So here this is current. Current flows through the resistance R. So we know that it is the virtual node. So VA is the virtual node. So here voltage at node A is zero. So we substitute VA is zero. So we'll get this equation as That is left side is left side we have v naught by rf, so that can we are considered that into right side. So v naught divided by rf, so what is the remaining currents are vr divided by the reference vr divided by 2 power 1 r multiple with d1, so up to we have vr divided by 2 power n r multiple with dn. So we know that this is output voltage is v naught is I naught into the feedback resistance rf. Okay, so what is I naught? So I naught is nothing but sum of this current. So the sum of current is depends the binary weighted resistance and then reference voltage. So here, what is I naught? I naught is V, I is V by R, so VR by R. So multiple with the binary weighted the input inputs are D1, D2 up to we have the Dn. So the output voltage V naught is I naught into RF. So now you substitute I naught is this equation, right? So we'll get this equation. So here, what is output voltage V naught? VR by VR into RF divided by R. So these are the binary binary terms. That is, resistors are, it is 2 power 1 minus 2 power 2. Binary weights are multiple with this, the resistance value R, right? So here, this input is the binary input. So the output is the analog output. So here the resistance values, feedback resistance and input resistance values are equal means here the full scale out full scale voltage is the reference voltage. So that is V naught equal to the reference voltage. Both are equal means R of R is equal to K, one equal means it is one, right? So here the output voltage is the reference voltage. So the output voltage is the full scale output voltage. So this is the transfer characteristics of the 3-bit binary weighted register D2A converter. So the input is the binary code. So it starts from 30 to 31, right? So what is the analog output? So it is analog output is from 0 to we have the 7 VR by 8. So input is the 00 means the analog output voltage is 0 voltage. So input is 001 means the analog output voltage is 1 by 8 VR. So up to we have the 111, right? So 111, so this binary word equivalent to binary input equivalent to the analog output is 7 VR by 8, right? So here this is the positive staircase of 3-bit weighted register transfer characteristics. So you know, we know that it is depending upon the switches, the reference voltage is either positive or negative. So what are the main drawback of this digital to analog converter? So here, one end we have the resistance value is only 2 power 1 R, right? Then here the last end, the dead end is we have the 2 power n R. Here one end is the resistance value is small value, then last end is the last one is here is 2 power n r, right? So here the maximum resistance value, right? So here we can this resistance value, small and large resistance value in that integrator circuit, we are going to fabricate that, right? Resistance in that one integrator circuit is very difficult. Low small value and large value in that particular IC, so it is very difficult. So it is impractical to fabricate the large of resistor value in integrated circuit, and voltage drop across the large resistance also here due to bias current also affects the accuracy of the converter. So small value resistors is loading effect will occur, right? So this is a major problem in that binary weighted register D2A converter. So this, the binary weighted register D2A converter, which is also called as the current to voltage converter. So we have input, we have the current, we have the reference voltage, we have binary resistors values are there. So current flows through the each resistance are from I naught to IN. So inputs are current, outputs are voltages. So it is also called as the current to voltage converter. Okay, so here the drawback is we cannot able to fabricate the large and the small resistance in that integrator circuit. So this will affect the small resistance, means this will affect the loading loading effect may occur. Then large resistance means bias current also affects the accuracy of this converter. So we avoid that this drawback, so we go for the fixed resistance R2 to R LADA D2A converter. Here we have used only the two resistance R and 2R, only two resistance. So depending upon the switch position, the switch position is the either right side is it which is connected to the reference voltage minus VR, then left side means which is connected to the ground. So here the binary word we are considered here is 001. So here it is 0. So 0 means it is connected to ground here, left position. So here also 0, so it is connected to ground, left position. So here it is 1 means which is connected to the right position, that is connected to the reference voltage is minus VR, right? Minus VR. Then here, now we are analyze this input side. So we have a fixed resistance are there. So we are going to simplify the resistance value. So we depending upon the resistance connected, either it is parallel or series, right? So which is connected ground. So the two resistance are connected parallel, which is connected with here the series, right? Then these two resistance are connected in parallel, which is connected with here it is series. So we draw the equivalent circuit, we simplify the resistance value. So here these are connected. 2R is connected in parallel, so we'll get the resistance values are R, then R plus R is 2R, then that 2R is connected with the parallel, so we'll get the R. So here finally, here this resistance are connected with connected to this resistance should be series, so we'll get the final resistance value is 2R. So this 2R is connected with the node C, right? This connected with node C, which is grounded. Then one more resistance 2R is connected with, we have the reference voltage, right? The same node, we have 2R resistance is there, which is connected with the reference voltage VR. Then we have the input resistance also there. So anyway, so this is the equivalent circuit of that circuit diagram. So here we are simplify that. Now these two resistance are connected in parallel. So we are simplify the resistance value, it is 2/3, right? So here 2/3 R is there. Then we have here we have 2/3 R. Then we have 2R resistances there. So now we are going to find the voltage across that node C. So what is the node C voltage? So the node C voltage is here is that is minus VR. Okay. So minus VR, we have the 2/3 resistance divided by we add these two resistance values. So we'll get the node. That is node C voltage is minus VR divided by 4. Minus VR divided by 4. So we are finding the node voltage of this inverting amplifier. So minus VR divided by 4, which is connected to the inverting terminal. So what is the output voltage? So you know that the inverting amplifier gain is minus RF by R. So here the feedback resistance is R2R. So minus 2R divided by R. So multiple with the reference voltage, the input voltage is minus VR divided by 4. So we'll get the output voltage is half of the full scale voltage. So here the drawback is current flowing through the resistance. The fixed resistance is changes. This will change the input data. That means more power dissipation causes heating. So the current flows through the resistance is high means due to heating. So this will affect the input binary word. So this will create the serious problem, that is a non-linearity problem. So we cannot get the digital input equivalent analog output voltage. So it is a serious problem. So we avoid that serious problem. So we go for the inverted R2-2R LiDAR type D2A converter. So in the inverted R2-2R LiDAR type D2A converter, we have the two mode, that is current mode as well as voltage mode. So first one is the current mode. So in that current mode, here the here is the resistance R, that is equal resistance R, which is the circuits are connected either which is connected to the inverting mode as well as is connected to the non-inverting mode. Non-inverting mode. So here we are considered the binary word is here 100. So one means So one means which is connected to here inverting mode, but in this node it is virtually grounded, right? So anyway, it is virtually grounded. So here heating problem does not occur. So here the current flows through this resistance. This will not affect the binary word. Let us say this will not change the input binary word, so that we go for the inverted R2-2R LiDAR type. So here the position is the left side means which is connected to the ground, actual ground. So here, that means that is the switch is logic zero. That is logic zero. That is the left position means current flows through the 2R resistance flows to the ground. So it is the right position means current flows through the 2RS sinks to the virtual ground. So here the current is divides equally. So this will not produce any heating. This will not affect the binary world. So that we use this type of converter. So current divides are equally divided. Here is see this circuit diagram. So here we are considered the current sources. Current is 2 microamps. So in that particular node, A node. So here we have 2 microamps. So in that A node, the currents are equally divided. So here 1 microamp, here is 1 microamp, right? So in that B node, the currents are equally divided. Okay, so 0.5, 0.5. Then this node, where currents are equally divided, 0.25, 0.25, 0.25. So the currents are equally divided. So does the there is no the here is a maximum current does not flow through the one resistance. Minimum current does not flow through the another resistance. So equal currents are flows through the each resistance R to R. So this will not affect the input. This will not affect the input. So here you just write the current equations I1, I2, I3. I3, so it is dependency, the reference voltage, and then the resistance value, fixed resistance value. So we write the equations for output voltage. So the output voltage is the reference voltage, and then this D1 to D3. We have three bit, we are considered 3-bit. So D1 to D2, D3. Into 2 power minus 1, 2 power minus 2, 2 power. So this is the output voltage equations. Then we have voltage mode. So in voltage mode also here, we are convert the, digital input is converted into analog output. So the maximum output voltage, the minimum output voltage, it should be dependency. Here we have the two sources are there. So maximum output voltage dependency, this voltage source, maximum output voltage, maximum dependency this VH as well as the low voltages depends this VL. So how we can say that the output voltage, this is the non-inverting amplifier. This circuit is connected with this non-inverting amplifier. So consider here the node voltage is VS, right? VS. So now we derive the VS voltage at the node S. So voltage at the node S, it should be voltage at the node S varies, dependency 2 power minus n, okay, binary values are 2 power minus n, right, binaries are 2 power minus n, then it depends the difference between the two voltage sources, high voltage source and low voltage source, difference. So here, so the VS is various, the node voltage is various, so here is, various in steps of only 2 power minus n VH minus VL. So the minimum output and maximum output voltage should be. So minimum output voltage of this converter should be depends the VL source, VL minimum. Then the maximum is depends the VH high, that is maximum output voltage source VH minus of 2 power minus n VH minus VL. So here these voltages are given to the non-inverting amplifier. So what is the output voltage? So the output voltage, it is a non-inverting amplifier. So the gain is 1 plus R by R1 multiple with the VS. Multiple with the VS. So here 1 plus R2 divided by R1 multiple with the VS. So here this is the voltage mode D2A converter. D2A inverted R2 to R LiDAR type D2A converter. So we have the two mode. That is, one is the current mode, another one is the voltage mode. So current mode is here, the currents are equally divided. So there is no heating problem here. In this will not, there is no current flows through the resistances. Maximum one resistance is maximum, another resistance is minimum. This will not affect the input binary world, right? So that we go for the inverted type. So we have two mode, current mode as well as voltage mode. So then current mode, currents are equally divided. So here we can able to convert correct, that is able to convert the digital is converted into analog output voltage without any changes, right? So this is voltage mode. This is also convert the digital input into analog output voltage. Okay, so this is the D2A converter. So we have discussed the different types of D2A converter. So one is the binary weighted register D2A converter. Then second one is the R2-2R LADA type D2A converter. So next one is the inverted R2-2R LADA type D2A converter, right? So this class we are going to discuss different types of analog to digital converter. So here we have the different types of analog to digital converter. So here in basic AD analog to digital converter provides the functions just opposite to the digital to analog converter. So here this analog to digital converter can accept the analog input voltage VA and produce the binary output word. So the binary output word from MSB to LSB, it is D1 to DN. So how we represent the binary value in functionally. So here the function value D is represent D1 2 power minus 1 plus D2 2 power minus 2 plus D3 2 power minus 3 up to we have the DN 2 power minus N. So here D1 is the MSB bit, then DN is the LSB bit. So here in analog to digital converter, we have two additional control line is there. So the first line is the starting start line, then EOC line, that is the end of conversion line. So in start line which indicate the input to tell the analog to digital converter when to start the conversion. Then end of conversion is, so the output to announce when the conversion is completed. So we have the two control lines there. So where we use this analog to digital converter is, so we are using microprocessor interfacing and which is used in LCD and LED display. So here we have different types of analog to digital converter is there. So this class we are going to discuss the different types of analog to digital converter. So the first type is the direct type analog to digital converter. Then second one is the integrating type analog to digital converter. So first indirect type, it is further classified into two types. That is flash type A2D converter. Then we have the successive approximation type A2D converter. So in direct type means here this analog to digital converter is compare the given analog signal is with the internally generated equivalent signal, right? So here this is the direct type analog to digital converter. So we'll see one by one for the different types of analog to digital converter. Then we should know that what is the integrating type analog to digital converter. So integrating type is, it is indirect manner. First we are changing the analog input signal into linear functions of time or frequency. Then after that, we are going to convert into digital code. So this is the that is integrating type analog to digital converter. So here we have the two, further it is classified into two types. That is the first one is the single slope analog to digital converter. Then we have the dual slope analog to digital converter. So this class we'll discuss about the first type, direct type analog to digital converter. So in first we have the flash type. So it is also called as the parallel comparator, flash type A2D converter. So now we'll see the circuit diagram. So here we have the comparator, right? So here we have eight comparators there, right? So then we have the eight line to three line priority encoder, right? So it is a three bit analog to digital converter circuit. It consists of, we have the resistive divider network, right? So this is a resistive divider network, and then we have the eight comparator from X0, that is X0 to X7. So the output of the comparator, we are denoted X0 to X7. Anyway, we have the eight comparator. Then we have the eight line to three line priority encoder. So here, in each node, so here the resistive divider, a comparison voltage is available, right? So all the nodes we have comparison voltages are available. So here we have eight comparator. So here in first the positive terminal, right? So the positive terminal, here we are going to give the analog input voltage. So the analog input voltages, we are represent the VA. The negative terminal, that is inverting terminal, we are going to give the reference voltage. So it is given to the resistive divider network, right? So here all the resistors are equal value, right? So here all the resistors are equal value. So the voltage levels available at each node, voltage level available at each nodes are equally divided. So are equally divided between the reference voltage VR and the ground. So here, what is the comparator input? Here is the analog input as well as the reference voltage, equally divided the reference voltage. So here the purpose of this circuit is, so we are going to convert analog into digital. So this circuit compare the analog input voltage VA at analog input voltage VA as the each of the node voltage, right? As the each of the node voltage. So here, in general, you know that what is the comparator output? We have the two input terminal, then one output. So here, the two input terminal voltages are compared, right? So VA is greater than, that is positive terminal voltage is greater than the negative terminal voltage. So the output should be 1. Then negative terminal voltage is greater than the positive terminal voltage, so the output should be 0. So both the voltages are equal means, the two terminal voltages are equal means, so here the output of the comparator is it attains the previous value. So this is the truth table of the comparator. Everyone should know that, right? Okay. Then we have, yes, just wait a minute. So we'll see the truth table of the class type A2D converter. So here this is the truth table of the class type A2D converter. Each node we have the reference voltages. This is the each node we have the input voltages zero. This is the input voltages. So this is the comparator output. This is the eight line to three line priority encoder output. So here for this range, right? So the analog input voltages for this range, right? Okay, so this range, which is first compare, this voltage is compared with the non-inverting terminal voltage, right? So the two voltages are compared here, right? So what is the output of the comparator? So the first comparator is enabled. So X naught is enabled. So we'll get the output of the three line priority encoder is 000, right? So the first one comparator is enabled. So other comparator is 0. So the next for this voltage range, that is VR by 8 to 2VR by 8. So here the second comparator is enabled. So here second one and first one is the enabled. So the remaining comparator output is 0. So here what is the equivalent binary is 001. So here the next 2VR by 8 to 3VR by 8. So here is the third comparator is enabled. So first three comparator is enabled. So the remaining comparator is disabled, right? So here the comparator can compare the analog voltage with the range of the reference voltage, right? So depending upon this voltages, right? So here the comparator can be enabled. That is non-inverting terminal voltage is greater than the inverting terminal voltage means. So here the comparator is enabled. So which is the equivalent binary output. Then here is up to we have the 7VR by 8 to VR. So here in that range, so here all the comparator is enabled. Here the what is the binary output? It is 111, right? So here the binary output is from 30 to 31. So here we need the comparator is, right? So we need the comparator is in that is a 3-bit priority encoder. We need the comparator is 2 power n minus 1. See some wait ma. Sorry for the inconvenient. Okay, we need the comparator is 2 power n minus 1, right? So here n is 3 bit. So n is 3 bit means, see. So we need the 2 power n minus 1 comparator, right? So here the disadvantages means we have more number of comparator is necessary, right? So in class type comparator, that is class type A2D converter, we need more number of comparator is required. So what is the advantages? So the advantages of this class type are a high speed class type or parallel type, right? It is also called as fastest type A2D converter. So it is a high speed converter. The conversion time is only that is 100 microseconds or it is less, right? So the conversion time is limited by limited by the speed of the comparator, and then we have one priority encoder, right? So here the conversion time is limited by the speed of the comparator and priority encoder. Then what are the disadvantages of this this converter is we need more number of comparators. So depending upon the number of bit, right? So here 3-bit, we need the 7 comparator, right? So suppose here 2-bit, we need the 3 comparators. Suppose we have the 4-bit analog to digital converter, we need the 15 comparator, right? So depending upon the number of bits, that is number of bit increases, means we need the more comparator. So that is the only one disadvantage of this flash type or parallel type A2D converter. But advantages is it is a high speed. Okay, so high speed, and this is a high speed analog to digital converter, because here the conversion is take place simultaneously, right? So here the conversion is take place simultaneously rather than it is sequentially. Then this is one type of analog to digital converter. Then we have the successive approximation type analog to digital converter. So this converter is a very efficient. This is n-bit conversion, right? Okay, this is the very efficient analog to digital converter. We have n-bit conversion, means we need the here n clock period. Okay, it is usually very efficient code. So here we have to convert the binary word as, that is binary is n-bit, means we need the n clock periods. So here the binary data is the 8-bit, right? So we need the 8 clock pulses. So here at 8-bit converter would require the 8 clock pulse to obtain the correct digital output. So the circuit uses only the successive approximation register. So SAR is the successive approximation register to find the required value of, which is used to find the required value of the each bit. Required value of the each binary bit, right? So by each binary value, so by trial and error method. So we know that here all the analog to digital converter, we have the two control liners there. So the first one is the start, right? So the start line is which indicate the input to tell the analog to digital converter when to start the conversion. So here the next one is the end of conversion. So here the output. So we are getting the output, means the output put to announce when the conversion is completed, right? So this end of conversion is this control signal is enabled, means so here the conversion is completed. So that time only this end of conversion is enabled, right? So here it is a trial and error method. So in trial and error method, we are going to convert the analog equivalent digital data. Okay, so now we are going to see the operation of the successive approximation type analog to digital converter. So here it consists of the one comparator, then successive approximation resistor and digital to analog converter, right? So here we have the comparator, we have the two input terminals. So here we compare the two voltages, VA as well as VD. So the comparator output is either high or low. So it is given to the successive approximation register. So here we are getting the binary word, right? Okay. So that binary equivalent analogous here is converted. So this is the VA is representing the analog equivalent correct digital representation, right? Okay. Then this is VDS. So here correct digital data, which is that is trial and error method, we are going to find the digital output, right? So here we compare the analog voltages are VA as well as VD. So VD is from the digital to analog converter. Okay, digital to analog converter. So how this circuit operates is, so here with the arrival of the start command. So the first start command, the SAR sets the MSB bit. First, the MSB bit is 1. Okay. First, the MSB bit is 1. All other bits are 0. That is from D2 to D8 is 0. Okay. So the trial code is 170. So 170. So which is given into analog to digital converter, right? So this is digital to analog converter. So this converter convert the digital data into analog, right? Digital data into analog. So which is the input of the one input of the comparator. So now VA is, right? So here, depending upon the comparator voltages, right? So upon non the terminal voltages, which are, that is the non-inverting terminal voltage is greater means the comparator output is high. Otherwise, it is zero. Okay, otherwise it is zero. So here, see here from the table, you can understand the approximation type converter operation, right? So here, this is considered. This is the analog equivalent, that is whatever we are given the input, right? So that input equivalent digital, right? So this is the correct digital representation of the analog input. So initially here, the successive approximation register output, we are consider one, first the MSB bit is one, the remaining bits are zero. The remaining bits are zero, right?
Record.
So here VA is greater than, VA is greater than the this VD, right? So here VA is greater than VD. So here the initial out, the output is one. Output is one, right? So next here the output is one means, so here this LSB, this MSB bit is we are going to reset. The next we are considering the next step, right? So here the remaining bits are as it is. Okay, so VA is, this condition is satisfied means, so we are check the this bit, right? This MSB bit. So we are going to reset, right? So zero is one. Okay, zero is one. So now we compare. So now this is the successive approximation approximation register output, right? So now we compare the VA with VD. So here VA is greater. So now it is, now VA is greater, right? So VA is greater means, so here the comparator output is the high output, right? So this is the initial output, right? This is the next output. So here the comparator output is high. So comparator output is high. So we are next, we are considering the next bit, right? So the next bit is zero means we are reset that bit. So if we are getting one. So here now we compare VA and VD. So here VD is greater, right? So VD is greater means, VD is greater means, so here the comparator output is zero. VD is greater means the comparator output is zero. So here we reset that this bit, right? So the third bit we have here, we are reset, but here the condition is VD is greater than VA, right? VD is greater than VA. So here we are going to reset. So the trial bit is going to be reset. The next consider the next LSB bit is one, right? The next bit consider one. So now we compare both, right? So here VA compare with VD. So here is VA is greater, right? So VA is greater. So VA is greater means, greater than VD means the comparator output is one. Okay, the comparator output is one. The next one is, the comparator output is one means, so here we are going to reset the so here we are considering the next bit, right? So the next bit is zero is one here. So now we compare these two bits. So here VA is, here is VA is less than VD, right? So VA is less than VD, that is VD is greater. So this bit is, we are reset previous step. So we are going to again reset. So here VD is greater, right? So we reset. The next we are going to check the next bit. So zero is here going to be one. So now we compare, but both the VA and VD digital representations are equal, but we cannot check this two bit, this LSB bit. So here you consider, here this should be a initial output. So initial output is, we are considered one. So here is, it should be one. Okay, the next we are going to reset the we have two remaining bit. We are going to check this two bit, right? So here it is zero is one. So now we compare. So now VD is greater, right? So VD is greater means, so the comparator output is zero. So we reset this. Okay, so in the next we are going to check the next bit. So in this way we are going to check the LSB bit, right? From MSB to LSB bit. So here also VD is greater. So here the comparator output is zero. So we are going to reset. So the last step, we are compare the two. We are here is, we are checking all the binary data, right? So from LMSB to LSB bit, all the bits are, we are trial and error method we are checked, right? So now here VA equal to VD. So here all the subsequent bits are tested, right? So here the 8 bits are tested. Okay, the 8 bits are tested here. So here how we are defined the conversion time, analog to digital conversion time, we have one formula. So the formula is TC equal to T into N plus 1, right? So where T is the clock period. So here N is the number of bits. Okay, so this is the successive approximation type analog to digital converter. So trial and error method. Okay, so this is trial and error method. We are going to convert analog into digital. Okay. analog into digital. So this is the direct type. This is the direct type analog to digital converter. Okay, so this class we are going to discuss the analog to digital converter. It is the integrating type analog to digital converter. So here it perform this analog to digital converter perform the conversion is in indirect manner. It is not a direct manner. So first, changing the analog input signal to linear function of the time or frequency, and then to digital code. So here we have the two types of the integrating type analog to digital converter. We will see one by one. So this topic is under the GATE syllabus. Now we discuss the operation and operation of the single slope and dual slope A to D converter. Then we will see the some GATE question, right? So here, this is the circuit diagram of the single slope A to D converter. So here is, it consists of this single slope A to D converter is, it consists of the comparator and AND gate. We have the BCD to binary counter, the RAM generator and timing and control circuit. Then we have latches and then decoder driver circuits, right? So now we'll see the operation of this single slope A to D converter. At the start, the reset signal is first enabled. So here the timing and control signal is which produce the reset signal. So which reset the RAM generator as well as the BCD or binary counter. So here the counter is first resetted as zero. At the start, we are going to reset the counter. So we are going to give the analog input voltages Vin. Okay, so we are convert this analog voltages converted into equivalent digital code using that single slope A to D converter. So which is given into non-inverting terminal. So we know that the comparator positive terminal voltage is greater than the inverting terminal voltage, means we are getting the output is high. So here Vin is positive, which is given to non-inverting terminals. We are getting the comparator output is high. So which enables the gate, right? So which enables the gate. So here, this gate output is given to the binary counter. So the binary counter can start the counting, right? So here the binary counter can start the counting. See, start the counting. So here, start the counting, right? So here is, start the counting. So here, the high output voltage of the comparator is the high output voltage of this comparator. See, high output voltage of the comparator enables the AND gate, that is, which allows the clock signal, okay, which allows the clock signal to reach the counter, and also high output is start the RAM generator, right? So here we are getting some output, right? So the reference voltage. So the reference voltage goes positive. Okay. So until it exceeds the input voltage Vin, means, right? So now the V reference is greater than the Vin. It means the comparator output is goes high. The comparator output is goes low. So the comparator output is low means which disable the AND gate, right? Which disable the AND gate, which turn to stop the binary counter, right? So first, comparator output is high means which turn to start the counter, right? And RAM generator output also goes high. Now the comparator output is low means which disable the AND gate. So here, disable the AND gate, then which turn to stop the clock of the counter, right? So here the control circuit is, we are having timing and control circuit. So now the control circuit provides it stops the counter. So the control circuit is provides the last signal, right? So initially the control signal gives the reset signal to the RAM generator as well as the BCD or binary counter. Here the binary counter can stop counting means the timing and control circuit gives the last signal, right? So the last signal to the latches, right? So here, which is used to last the, this latch is used to last the, right? Which can store the counter data. Okay, so the latched data is so displayed, which is displayed to the, we have the display devices, 7-segment display devices, through the, we have the one decoder circuit. Okay, so here is, so we are getting the analog equivalent digital output here, right? So digital output, analog equivalent digital count is, right? So digital count. Here is the counter can count the number of clock pulses, right? So that is analog equivalent. Digital code is displayed in that 7-segment display. So this is for the single slope analog to digital converter. Okay. So here in this type, we have one disadvantages is there. So it is the, sorry, later. So here the disadvantage is it is the resolution is very less, right? So the resolution is very less. So here the analog to digital converter is not a stable one. Okay, so the variation of the RAM generator means, okay, so this the variation of the RAM generator is due to time as well as temperature also, right? So here it is not a stable one. This converter is not a stable one, right? So here input voltage, it is the input voltage sensitivity, right? So this is due to the sensitivity of this voltages, right? So it gives the lot of problems. So it does not so here is that is the disadvantage of the single slope analog to digital converter. So that we go for the dual slope. Okay, so dual slope A2D converter. So now we'll see the operation of the dual slope A2D converter. So here it is the circuit diagram, that is block diagram of the dual slope A2D converter. So which consists of, here we have the integrator, then comparator, then we have one gate that is AND gate, then binary counter, then we have the latches. Okay, so we have the latches. So this is the dual slope A2D converter. So here it is also indirect method, right? This integrating like one method. So it is a indirect method for convert the analog into digital, analog data into digital conversion, right? Digital data. Where the analog voltage and the reference voltages are here is, it is not directly converted. First, it is converted into time or frequency. So here is time by an integrator. We are using integrator. So the analog voltage is converted into first time. Okay, time. And then it is measured by the counter. Okay, so here it is measured by the counter. So now, so here is initially, so first consider here initially at time t equal to 0. Okay, so the analog switches initially are considered, which is connected to the VI, that is the analog input voltage VI. Okay, at the analog input voltage, now it is integrate, right? So we have the integrate circuit. So this voltage is given to the inverting terminal of the integrator. So the integrator is integrating the analog input voltage. So what is the output voltage? So the output voltage of the integrator, it should be, so V naught is minus 1 by R1 C1 integral of 0 to T1 period, right? So VI dt. So here for the T1 period, so 0 to T1 period, so the integrator integrate the analog input voltage. So here analog input voltage given to the inverting terminal of the integrator. So we'll get the minus of. So minus VI T1 divided by R1 C1. So this is the integrator output voltage, where R1 C1 is the integrator time constant. Then here is VA is a constant, assumed here is it is constant over the integration period is 0 to T1. So in that 0 to T1 period, the input voltage is constant, right? So here the integrator can integrate the input voltage VI. So it is negative, right? So it is negative means, so here we are getting the slope is integrator output slope is like that, right? So at t equal to 0, the integrator start integrating the input voltage, right? So from 0 to T1 period. Okay, so you'll get the negative slope, right? Okay, so the input is given to the inverting mode. So here the output of the integrator is, it depends VI divided by R1 C1. So R1 C1 is the time constant, right? Then V naught is direct proportional to this VI. Okay, so the end of the T1 period, right? So the end of the T1 period. So here, consider here, see the block diagram first, right? From that, you'll understand. So here we have the, at the end of the T1 period, that is the, we have the, that is, this is negative, right? So the output voltage is negative. So which is given to the comparator, negative terminal. So we are getting the positive. Comparator output is goes high, that is a positive one. So which enables the AND gate, right? So clock signals also given to this AND gate. Both the input signals are high means we are getting the output is high. So the binary counter can start the counting, right? So here, analog voltage, now we are integrating the analog input, right? So equivalent digital counters, here the binary can count the analog equivalent digital count, right? So at the end of the T1 period, right? So at the end of the T1 period, see, at the end of the T1 period, okay, at the end of the T1 period, so what will happen is, so here the switch position is, right? So here the switch position is, it changed from, so here is the counter can count the data, right? So here count the data means, first is initially the LSB is 0, MSB also 0, right? So we're going to count the data means MSB bit is going to be increased, right? So here you will get the high MSB value means, which is given to that is the control input to the switches, right? Through the, we have the flip flop. So the switch position is changed from up to down. So here the switch is connected to the now the reference voltage, right? So the reference voltage is we are considering here minus V reference voltage, which is given to the inverting terminal of the integrated circuit, right? So here it is inverting, so this is also negative. So what is the output of the integrator? So the integrator output is going to be positive, right? So it is positive means here the comparator output is the low output. So the low output is which disabled the gate, right? Which disabled this AND gate. Okay, so it is disabled the AND gate. So here disable the AND gate. So here is the previously we have integrate the analog input, right? So analog input equivalent digital count is here, right? The digital count is consider the end of the T1 period. We have the 2n clock, that is 2n period means that period MSB is goes high, right? So then after that only the switch's position is changed from VI to the V reference voltage, right? So the V reference voltage. So here that counted, right? So analog equivalent, this count is given to the output latch block, right? So here this circuit, so which is we are getting the here the digital output. Anyway, so here from this slope we are understand, right? We are understand the operation of the integrator. So here at the T1 period, up to T1 period, 0 to T1 period, we are integrate the input voltage VI. From T1 to T2 period, we are integrate the reference voltage. Okay, so here the reference voltage is negative means, so here the slope should be positive, right? Okay, the slope should be positive. So up to it reaches zero, right? So here it reaches zero means, right? It reaches zero means, so here is, it reaches zero means it is disabled. So here AND gate produce that is a low output. So the counter can stop the number of counting, right? So only we are integrate the analog input, right? So that is equivalent digital counters, digital count here we have, right? So from the latch circuit we are getting the digital output, that is analog equivalent, this analog input voltage equivalent digital output. Okay, so here how we can say that here is charging, and consider this is the charging voltage, right? So charging voltage from 0 to T1 period is VI by R1C1. Then this is the discharging voltage, right? From T1 to T2 period. So we are equate this to VI T1 divided by R1C1, VI T2 divided by R1C1. So we are getting the end of the T2 period, it should be VI divided by R into T1, right? Into T1. So here T2 is directly proportional to the input voltage VA. Then here VR and T1 is constant one, right? So it constant. So here VR and T1 is constant. So here is the binary digital output of the counter, right? The binary digital output of the counter. So here the binary digital output of the counter gives the corresponding digital value, right? Corresponding digital value for time period T2, at the end of the period is T2. So hence it is also directly proportional to the input voltage, right? Input voltage. So here, so what is the digital output? So the digital output is how we can say that the digital output is count, right? Count divided by count per second into the T2 period, right? So T2 period. So here digital output is count divided count per second into T1. So that is T2. We are substitute. T2, so here T2 is T1 into VI divided by into R, right? So what is the advantage of this dual slope A2D converter is, it is highly accurate, it is, the cost is very low, it is very immune to temperature, cost variation with, in R1 and C1. So the disadvantage of this analog to digital converter is that it is a low speed, right? So here in integrating type, analog to digital converter, we have two type, right? So the first one is the single slope A2D converter. So the single slope A2D converter is, here this converter is not a stable one. So here the variation is due to the temperature, right? So the variation is due to the temperature, and also it depends the time. Then input voltage is very sensitivity, right? It has also caused a lot of problems, so that we go for the dual slope A2D converter. So the dual slope A2D converter is perfectly integrate, integrate the analog input voltage, right? So the analog input voltage equivalent digital output we are getting in that output, right? So here this dual slope A2D converter is the best one, right? So here, which is highly accurate, it is, the cost is very low, And then only one disadvantage is the speed is very low, right? Compared to the single slope A2D converter, here the speed is low, but it is highly accurate. So we prefer the dual slope A2D converter. Then this is for different types of, in this class, we are discussing the different types of the analog to digital converter, that is single slope and dual slope A2D converter. Then next class, we will solve the some gate problem from this topic, right? So thank you.